now takes about $2-2.5 million to endow a chair at Duke. Costs a lot to sit down at Duke. I wish I were being paid $2 million a year to sit down, but apparently I'm not. This is a country with a lot of wonderful writers in it. And one of the things that we very much need at the present time in the English department is another poet. And I hope very much that we will start searching soon for a poet. And I suppose if I were challenged now to say how many great poets I thought there were in America at the present time. I mean, there are many dozens of fine poets, but there are also probably, I don't know, 10 really great poets in America. Most of them fairly well nailed down at some position somewhere else. So it's going to be a great challenge to us to find a really splendid poet and elicit the best from that poet. Plays are very like poetry unless they get too poetic. If you're writing a poetic drama, and Lord knows, I don't know when the last effective poetic drama was really written. It was probably sometime within the century after Shakespeare. Or really the comedies of Oscar Wilde, which are poetic in a very different kind of way. Then yes, you really are true that a play has to have that degree of absolute firmness, of intent, of candor, without ever bogging down in sort of excessive attempts at, you know, beauty. Yeah, this Jubilee weekend at Duke was a tremendous excitement, to say the least. I've had lots of excitements in my life, but I think this was one of the highest quality, one of the ones most that lends itself most to being talked about. I'd say I had a hell of a good time, which is the highest tribute I could give to it. It wasn't solemn, it wasn't somber. It wasn't like Reynolds Price has completed 50 years of teaching and 75 years of life. I think it seemed like the name I had originally given it, more in hope than certainty, which was Jubilee. And it's an old Hebrew word, and it was a great celebration, and it seemed like that. I felt like I was both being celebrated and was celebrating. I've long since given up being ashamed of the fact that I cry a lot. I know when in very early grade school, like the second and third grade, I can remember kids saying, "You're crying, Reynolds," on the playground or something. And I'd say, if they were telling me a funny story, because I generally cry about something that's funny or likable as opposed to something that's deeply sad. And they would say, "You're crying, Reynolds," and I'd say, "No, I'm not, it's just the wind in my eyes." And then they'd say, "There ain't no wind out here." But the years have gone by, and I've just long since ceased being concerned about my tendency to cry, my tendency to cry at happy movies and so forth. But, Tony noticed it, and I'm very glad she acknowledged it publicly. I've known for a very long time, certainly at least since the death of my father, when I was 21 years and 21 days old, that you don't make any serious plans. In fact, I especially love the old Jewish saying, and if you want to make God laugh, tell him your plans.